Good evening, everyone. How are you doing?
I'm fine, teacher.
Good evening. Great, yeah, great. I was checking on the chat, some a little chat, right? Chit chat. Yeah, this is very healthy to be on time and practice all the skills that we can as much as we can. Okay, because this is the space, right? This is the space where we practice English during the whole day. So welcome everyone. Today is your number six class, right? Number six class. And we are going to start unit two. Yay, unit two, excellent. So this is our first class of unit two. What do you think about this? How do you feel? Vamos a tomar estos tres minutitos, ok? Tres minutitos para que platiquemos un poquito de acerca cómo vamos, ok? Miren, la primera cosa que quiero pedirles es que ahora vieron ustedes, enviaron un mensaje. Esas son voces de alerta, ¿verdad? Nos están diciendo pues que están viendo que no estamos conectados, no estamos cumpliendo con ese requisito, ¿verdad? De no conectarnos y de no participar, ¿ok? En el tiempo que corresponde, que son 120 minutos. Así que les pido su colaboración. Este es un programa muy estricto, ¿verdad? Quiero hacérselos manifiesto. Este es un programa muy estricto. Y pues es un gran beneficio y hay que aprovecharlo, ¿verdad? No queremos perder este beneficio por situaciones como esas, ¿verdad? De acerca de la asistencia, ¿verdad? Todos sacan excelentes calificaciones, ya vi sus calificaciones en las tareas y eso. Entonces, lo que nos falta ahorita para estar en el nivel correcto con los requerimientos, chicos, es eso. Estar los 120 minutos conectados. Hay que procurar, ¿verdad? Hay que tomar en cuenta que la lluvia, que el internet, que nuestra hora de salida del trabajo, que el espacio, qué sé yo, o alguna situación en la casa, celebraciones, todas esas cuestiones, hay que tomar en consideración que esto es serio, ¿verdad? Y que pues nos están controlando los requerimientos y tenemos que cumplir, ¿verdad? Bueno, lastimosamente pues yo estoy al frente, entonces yo tengo que decirlo, a mí no me gusta mucho eso. A mí me gusta más que juguemos, que estemos contentos y felices, pero hay reglas que cumplir. Entonces, por favor, les explico su colaboración en eso. Bien, aparte de eso, quería en estos otros dos minutitos que me quedan, para poder hablar de esto, es acerca de la metodología, para que nos pongamos así como en sintonía. Primero quiero saber quiénes de ustedes hicieron el curso anterior, el módulo 1 con nosotros. El módulo 1, ¿quiénes lo hicieron acá? Ok.
Teacher. Okay. Mi teacher.
Ok.
Mi
teacher. Ok.
Mi teacher.
Ok. Y la otra pregunta, ¿estaban siempre ustedes juntos en este mismo grupo? O sea, ¿estaban juntos ustedes? ¿Se conocían desde el módulo pasado?
Con algunos, sí.
Ok.
Sí, con algunos.
Ok, muy
bien. Éramos 16 los que estábamos también en el grupo anterior.
Ok, gracias por esa información. Bueno, miren, la situación es esta. Les hago esa pregunta porque tenemos un backup, ¿verdad? Tenemos un contexto. Este es un programa que va de módulo en módulo. Primero se pone una base, luego vamos construyendo. Y es a manera de que vayamos realizando actividades que enriquezcan el vocabulario y que enriquezcan el uso. En este curso no vamos a estar enfocados en, digamos, en la manera académica, digamos, en la manera rígida de la gramática, sino que en la manera móvil de la gramática, en la manera activa. Entonces, la manera activa, ayer tuvimos una plática muy enriquecedora con Delmi, ¿verdad? Delmi creo que fue que quedó ayer. Y es muy importante que les manifieste a ustedes que nuestra metodología es que nos basamos en expresiones, ¿verdad? No vamos palabra por palabra porque ningún idioma lo vamos a aprender de esa manera. Sí, tenemos que identificar las cuatro habilidades. De las cuatro habilidades, detectemos cuál es la que más nos cuesta. Y al ver cuál es la que más nos cuesta, a esa le vamos a reforzar. Cuando usted se inscribe en un curso de inglés, normalmente, ¿qué es lo que usted quiere? Así, en general, ¿qué es lo que todos queremos? ¿Verdad?
Hablar,
exactamente. Entonces, póngale que si usted quiere aprender a cantar y se mete a un curso, ¿qué lo van a poner a hacer? A cantar, ¿verdad? Ahora, ese es un curso en donde usted quiere aprender a hablar inglés. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que tenemos que hacer? Hablar inglés, ¿verdad? Entonces, ahorita el módulo 1, el módulo 2 son para poner bases y bases para que podamos ir soltando un poco ya el vocabulario, ¿verdad? Vamos poniendo un poquito de vocabulario y de una vez el uso, vocabulario y el uso. Entonces, nuestra metodología no es rígida, ¿verdad? Ahora, quisiera pues que nos pongamos de acuerdo y que entremos en esto, que necesitamos participación de todos en las actividades, ¿ok? Bien, dicho esto, solo quiero recordarles también que aunque nosotros terminamos día miércoles, el día viernes también tienen que quedar al día las tareas que corresponden hasta el día viernes, ¿verdad? Entonces, quiere decir que la tarea de hoy y la tarea de mañana tiene que quedar subida el día de mañana. Ya no podemos esperar que estas dos se suban hasta el miércoles, ¿verdad? Estas dos tienen que subirse el viernes, ¿ok? Bien, ¿alguna pregunta acerca de la metodología? ¿Algún comentario? ¿Algo que quieran decir acerca de cómo vamos?
Ok, yo. Termina.
Ok. ¿Se sienten bien cómo vamos?
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Yes, teacher.
Ok. ¿Alguna sugerencia que alguien quisiera dar acerca del curso? ¿Cómo vamos hasta ahorita? Vamos bien. Ok. Muy bien, entonces vamos a comenzar el día de hoy. We are going to start a class. I'm going to switch into English. That's the other requirement. I have to speak English 100% over here, okay? So I try not to speak Spanish, but sometimes we need, and I do it. I'm kind of flexible on that, but we have to try. We have to try and we have to push, right? We have to push ourselves to listen, okay? And okay, let's start then. I'm going to take the attendance right now. I see that we have almost everyone in, so let me go to the attendance list and I will call the roll, okay? So Alba Janet Lopez Avalos,
present.
Okay. Cecia Gemima Perez Ideos,
present.
Okay. David Alejandro Choto Martínez.
Present, teacher.
There we are. Debbie Stephanie Ramos Ramos.
Present, teacher.
Delmi Isabel Dera Salguero.
Present, teacher.
Daisy Carolina Sánchez Nieto.
Present.
Eva Leticia Contreras Argueta. Grecia Tatiana Rosales Campos. I saw someone on the chat who says so, right? It was only Patricia and David Alejandro, right? Okay, there we are. Grecia, are you there? Not Grecia yet? Okay. Juan Diego López Palacios.
Present, teacher.
Linda Alicia Valladares Argueta.
Present, teacher.
Luz Verónica Trujillo de Urbina.
Present.
Marco Adonai Villeda Alvarado. No Marco yet. Okay. Mayra Yanira Alfaro Posada. Mélida Isabel Bonilla Ventura.
Present.
Néstor Ariel Garzona.
Present, teacher.
Okay.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Néstor. Pablo Alberto Magaña Molina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Pablo. Patricia Eugenia Navarro de Rosales.
Present, teacher.
Great, Patricia, good. Roxana Marilín Pérez Ortiz.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Okay, here we are. And let's go and see what's going on for today, because we have a lot of exercises and a lot of activities to do tonight. So let me go there, because we have to introduce this thing. And jumping into, okay, here we go. As I was saying, today is class number 6, okay? And the topic for tonight is how to use frequency adverbs. How to use frequency adverbs. We are going to identify the frequency adverbs and how to use them in language and expressions, okay? So we're going to see what's our goal tonight. Our goal tonight is that you will be able to identify and use adverbs of frequency. Participants will be able to identify and use adverbs of frequency. Okay, that's the objective for tonight. Luz, please, can you read the class objective for tonight?
Participants will be able to identify and use adverbs of frequency.
Thank you very much. So we are going to identify, okay, the frequency adverbs. Now, our agenda. We are going to have a short bit feedback. It's not so short because we have to drill some points about the negative sentences and also about the time expressions and also the activities, because this is the base of the whole module. So we have to make this feedback well. We are going to have a conversation and a comprehension check as a manner of feedback. Then the topic for tonight, we are going to develop it, and how often do you and how often does she, okay? We're going to explain that and how to use them. Then we're going to have some breakout rooms activities, and the session for tonight is for Daisy Carolina Sanchez Nieto. Is Daisy in?
Yes, I am.
Okay, Daisy. So are you going to stay with me after the class tonight?
Yes.
Okay, great. Great, so let's go to our manuals, because in our manuals, we have the first activity for tonight. Okay, let's go here. I'm going to stop sharing. And it's in page 18. Let's go, everyone, please, to go, I mean, let's go to page 18 and your manual books. Okay, your handbook, page 18. There is an extra practice over there, okay? There is an extra practice, and in this practice, we are going to remember how to say things that don't happen, okay? Or things in a negative way. Let's remember that we are talking about activities in our workplaces, right? So this is the extra practice I was talking about. And this is how to use simple present negative statements. This is just a feedback and extra practice. For example, look at these two sentences. The first one, she does not work on weekends. She does not work on weekends. Let's see letter B. They do not have much time. They do not have much time. ¿Qué es lo que vemos acá? Acá vemos cómo se compone una oración simple, ¿verdad? Pero de una manera negativa. Hay que hacer la diferencia entre los pronombres I, you, we, and they y la forma que vamos a utilizar para he, she, it. ¿Ok? Entonces, veamos cómo es la forma gramatical. The subject plus the auxiliary do or does, depending on the subject, and the particle not, not, okay? Then the verb plus the complement. Ahora, déjenme anotarles acá algo muy, muy importante. La contracción, okay? We have do not, and we have does not. ¿Por qué usamos contracciones? ¿O por qué tenemos que enfocarnos nosotros en meter las contracciones en nuestro vocabulario? Ah, porque se asemeja mucho más a la forma coloquial o a la forma fluida y le van a entender mejor, ¿ok? Entonces, y usted va a entender también, va a empezar a visualizar y a enfocar cómo se pronuncia una contracción. Entonces, do not se contracta don't, okay? Don't. Does not se contracta doesn't, okay? Entonces, esto es muy importante. Hay que utilizar las contracciones as much as possible. As much as possible. Entonces, veamos el primer ejemplo que tenemos acá. Number one. Maria does not work at HPBC. Okay. Pero como vamos a usar la contracción, lo vamos a decir. Maria doesn't work at HPBC. Okay. Vamos a ver. Number two. Le vamos a pedir a Roxana que la lea, pero en vez de decirlo completo, lo dice contractado. Vamos a ver. Number two. Roxana, please.
Okay, Marcos doesn't stay late at work.
Excellent. Cecia, please, number three, contracted.
Juan and Pedro don't write reports.
Excellent. Number four. I'm sorry, I have to move this. Number four, please, Daisy. Contracted.
We don't send letters.
Excellent. So we have to be aware of using as much as we can the contractions. Okay, now vamos a ir a una última actividad para completar esta, okay, este cuadrito, pero no lo vamos a hacer escribiendo acá, sino más. Okay. Déjenme borrar esto. Ok. Vamos a escribir en este momento tres oraciones, ok, acerca de rutinas, actividades rutinarias relacionadas al trabajo o las que hacemos en la casa antes de llegar al trabajo, ¿verdad? Las vamos a escribir acá en manera positiva o afirmativa. A ver, quiero que me ayuden así, simple, una oración simple. Vamos a ver. Cecia, please, number one.
I don't.
Hagámoslas todas positivas. Primero.
Ah, okay. I get up.
Okay.
Early.
Okay. Every day or just weekdays?
Every day.
Okay. Okay. Number three. I have Cecia right here. So please, Cecia, number two. An affirmative one.
I drink.
Okay.
Coffee. I drink coffee.
Okay.
I drink coffee in the morning.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Cecia. Now, Luz, please, the third one. Una afirmativa.
I go to the room this Saturday.
To the room?
No, room. Como correr.
Okay, I go to run. Okay.
Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Okay. On Saturdays. Okay, great. So now I'm going to add two more. Okay. Solo voy a agregar dos más. I brush my teeth after each meal. Okay. I'm sorry, brush. One second. Se fue una C donde no es. Okay, brush. I brush my teeth after each meal, right? Vamos a ver, voy a agregar una última. Okay. Bien, tenemos cinco actividades acá. Vamos a cambiar un poquito la mecánica de solo escribirlo, ¿ok? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? We are going to play. What are we going to play? When someone says yes, someone says no, ¿ok? Entonces, yo voy a decir, por ejemplo, when Luz says yes, Cecia says no, ¿ok? ¿Qué quiero decir con esto? Luz dice la número uno, por ejemplo, que si fuera el primer turno, ¿verdad? Dice la número uno y Cecia tiene que decir la negativa, ¿ok? ¿Correcto? Are we okay, guys?
Okay. Okay,
okay,
teacher.
Okay, let's see then. We have... Okay, when Linda says yes, Mayra says no.
Okay.
Number one, right?
Mm-hmm. I get up early every day.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, teacher. Yo acabo de entrar, pero bueno, voy a intentar.
Okay.
Sería negativa.
Yes.
I get no. I get up early every day.
Okay. I don't get up early every day. Okay. Great. Vamos a hacer nuevamente la número uno. Vamos a ver. When Juan Diego says yes, Alba says no.
I drink coffee in the morning.
Okay.
Sería I don't drink coffee in the morning.
Okay, great. A ver, wow, vamos a repetir la número uno. Muy bien, ahorita, Juan Diego, Alba, you did a good job. Vamos a repetir la número uno. Vamos a ver. La número uno. When Nestor says yes, Linda says no. Number one.
I get up early every day.
I don't get up early every day.
Thank you. Then we go with number two. When Luz say yes, Nestor says no.
I drink coffee in the morning.
I don't drink coffee in the morning.
Excellent. When Cecia say yes, Daisy says no.
I go to run on Saturday.
I don't go to run on Saturdays.
Great. When David says yes, Alba says no.
Number four.
Yes.
I brush my teeth after each meal.
We can't hear you, Alba.
¿Cuál es la pronunciación de dientes, licenciada?
Teeth.
Teeth.
Teeth with the letter teeth. Z at the end. Yes, Z.
Teeth. Teeth.
Yes.
Okay. ¿Cuál es la diferencia de meal and food?
Excuse me?
What is the difference between meal and food?
Okay, meal is the time. Is the time during the day. For example, a meal is the breakfast. A meal is a complete plate with everything that you have to consume, right? Okay. And food is on the meal, right?
Okay. Right? Okay. I got it.
Okay, there you are. So now, Alba, we couldn't hear you.
I don't brush my teeth after each meal.
Okay, great. So when Alba says yes, Cecia says no. Number five.
I take a shower every day.
I don't take a shower every day.
Okay, Cecia, no problem. We understand. We respect that, says Nestor too, okay?
Okay, sorry.
So you don't take a shower. Okay, no problem. Okay, number one again. Number one again. When Pablo says yes, David says no. Pablo, are you there?
Number?
Okay, when you say yes, David says no. Number one.
I don't. I don't get up early every day.
Okay, then David, you say yes.
I get up early every day.
Thank you very much. Okay, guys, we did it already. So now we know how to create negative sentences for I, you, we, and they. It's the same structure. Now let's think about this. Vamos a ponerlo entonces para she and he, okay? For example, in this case, number one, she, las vamos a transformar. She, ¿cómo sería acá?
Doesn't.
Excellent. Doesn't get up early every day. So now, next one. Number two. ¿Cómo sería number two? She or he?
He doesn't drink coffee in the morning.
Okay, great. Now, number three.
She doesn't go to run on Saturdays.
Excellent. Number four.
He doesn't brush her teeth after each meal.
Okay. En este caso, como me dice he, sería his teeth. Okay. His
okay.
Right? Teeth. Mm-hmm. After each meal. Okay.
His es para he.
Exactly.
Y her es para she.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Su de él es his. Su de ella is her. Okay.
Okay.
There we go. Okay, number five, guys.
She doesn't take a shower every day.
There we go. Here we go. Okay. Y así era la extra práctica gramatical. Okay. Bien, voy a dejar de compartir acá. I'm going to stop sharing. And I'm going to show you now another activity. Vamos a pasar a otra actividad para recoger todo en una sola para pasar al siguiente tema después de esta. En esta nos vamos a tomar un poquitito de tiempo. A ver, porque necesitamos comprenderlo. ¿Ok? Entonces, vamos a ver una conversación between two people in a company. In this company, they are getting to know each other. Okay, they are getting to know. It means that they are knowing each other. It means it's the maybe the first time that they meet. Okay, probablemente es la primera vez que se conocen o se ven en persona, right? So, let's see. Es una sola conversación, la vamos a ver en dos partes, ¿ok? Es una conversacioncita que para ubicarnos un poquito sería lo que ya tenemos en consideración en vocabulario y en gramática hasta este momento, ¿ok? So, let's see and let's practice this conversation. This conversation is between this woman and this man. Do you see them over there? They are talking. Maybe it's the first time that they meet. So let's read. Please think about what's her name and what's his name. Okay. Now let's see. Hello, I'm Abigail Watson. What's your name? Hi, I'm Ernest Bellevue. Nice to meet you, Abigail. Nice to meet you too, Ernest. I'm sorry, what's your last name again? It's Bellevue. Is it B-E-L-B-U-E? No, it's B-E-L-L-V-I-E-W. Thank you. Are you the new truck driver? Yes, I am. What do you do? I'm the logistics manager's secretary. I schedule the deliveries and send a report by email to the 25 truck drivers. I organize the meetings and trainings. I also call clients every day to set the details for the weekly shipment they usually order. I invoice the delivery charge. It depends on the distance. It is about $200. Okay. Vamos a leerlo una vez más y luego, si tienen preguntas y acerca del vocabulario, me dicen. Okay. Hello, I'm Abigail Watson. What's your name? Hi, I'm Ernest Bellevue. Nice to meet you, Abigail. Nice to meet you too, Ernest. I'm sorry. What's your last name again? It's Bellevue. Is it B-E-L-B-U-E? No, it's B-E-L-L-V-I-E-W. Thank you. Are you the new truck driver? Yes, I am. What do you do? I'm the logistics manager's secretary. I schedule the deliveries and send a report by email to the 25 truck drivers. I organize the meetings and trainings. I also call clients every Friday to set the details for the weekly shipment they usually order. I invoice the delivery charge. It depends on the distance. It's about $200. Okay? Do you have any question about the vocabulary here?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Tell me.
What is the meaning of set?
Set, arreglar, poner, quedar de acuerdo.
Shipment.
Es cargamento o envío, right?
Invoice.
La factura.
Delivery.
Entregas.
Entregas. Thank you. That was my question.
Okay, great. Does anybody else have a question?
No.
Questions? Then, can you please tell me what's her name? What is her name?
Abigail.
Abigail.
Her name is Abigail.
Okay, good. And what's his name?
Ernest Belville.
Name Ernest Belville.
Belville, right? Belville. Mm-hmm. Belville. Okay, then let's answer these questions. What does Ernest Belville do?
Okay. I don't know. I don't remember.
Drive the
He's a truck driver.
A truck driver.
Great. Okay. I'm going to write. Here he is a truck driver. Great. Truck driver. What does Abigail Watson do?
She does
secretary.
Logic manager secretary.
Okay. She is
logistic manager secretary.
Okay, great. Cuando nos preguntan normalmente, what do you do? Hasta ahí hemos aprendido a decir nuestra profesión, nuestra ocupación, our profession or our job position, right? So, after that question, o en en el contexto de esa pregunta, cuando nos preguntan, what do you do? También nos están preguntando, si estamos en un contexto general, digamos, okay, si estamos en el contexto de nuestro trabajo y haga alguien de otro departamento y le pregunta, and what do you do? Okay, entonces no le están preguntando solo su job position. ¿Recuerdan ustedes la segunda plática o conversacioncita del manual? Hay alguien que tiene abierto su audio y nos está interrumpiendo, chicos. Vamos a ver. Okay. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que nos están preguntando? ¿Qué actividades realizamos? Okay. What activities do we do in our jobs? Okay, por eso Abigail Watson explains everything, right? Explains all her routine or her activities, right? Okay, bien, hasta ahí estamos bien. Vamos a ver a la siguiente parte, the next part of the conversation. Okay, vamos a ver. Abigail, when do you send the delivery schedule to the drivers? Well, I send the emails with the delivery schedule every Monday morning. When do you write the delivery report? I don't write the delivery report. The driver writes the report. When does the driver send the report? The driver doesn't send a report. The driver gives me the physical report at the office when finishes the daily deliveries. Okay, thank you for the information, Abigail. Okay, Ernest, have a nice day. See you tomorrow early in the morning. Okay. As we can see, this secretary coordinates all the truck drivers' activities, right? She does that. So let's see. We are going to read it again. Abigail, when do you send the delivery schedule to the drivers? Well, I send the emails with the delivery schedule every Monday morning. When do you write the delivery report? I don't write the delivery report. The driver writes the report. When does the driver send a report? The driver doesn't send a report. The driver gives me the physical report at the office when finishes the daily deliveries. Okay, thank you for the information, Abigail. Okay, Ernest, have a nice day. See you tomorrow early in the morning. Okay, bien. Vamos a ir a ver entonces las preguntitas para que hagamos un poquito de comprensión en esto que hemos leído, okay? It's a conversation, right? So, this comprehension check has only three questions. Number one, do you want to read the question number one? Let's see.
Yes, yes, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, please.
The question.
Yes, question number one, please read it.
What do the truck drivers do?
Okay. What do the truck drivers do? Ah, aquí, ¿qué nos están pidiendo? Mm-hmm.
¿Qué hace el conductor del camión?
Yes, but what are the activities, right, of the truck drivers? What do they have to do? Let's go and see in the conversation, right? Let's go back to the conversation and let's see the activities, okay? First of all, por default, sabemos que el truck driver es el que va a hacer the deliveries, ¿verdad? He is going to deliver products or the shipments, right? Or the packages. They are going to deliver. Okay.
The driver write the report.
Correct. What report? What report?
Delivery report.
Okay, great. What else?
And the driver gives
the physical report.
Physical report at the office.
At the end of the day, right? At the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Or at the end of the deliveries. Okay, how often does he have to do it? Daily, right? Daily, because they have daily deliveries.
Yes.
So, okay. Good. Okay, what do the truck drivers do? Can you repeat that? Deliveries. Right. Aquí estamos. Okay. Aquí está, deliveries, estoy en plural, ¿ok? Pero como estamos hablando también de todos los truck drivers, lo vamos a contestar, ¿ok? Como they, ¿ok? Si fuera solo uno, ok, sería he writes, ok. They write the, aquí lo vamos a unir de una vez, daily, delivery.
Daily delivery report.
Ok, great, ajá. He gives, they, we are in they. They gives the physical report at the end to the secretary. Vamos a poner, okay? At the end.
Teacher, it's okay, gives.
Yes, yes. Turns into, ok. Hay otros verbos, pero este está bien, ok. They gives the physical report to the secretary at the end of the day. Good. So now we know what do the truck drivers do. Well, they do the deliveries, they write the daily delivery report, they gives the physical report to the secretary at the end of the day, ok. Vamos a ver. Tenemos otra preguntita. We have another question. Let's see. Okay, here we go. How many truck drivers receive the delivery schedule? How many truck drivers receive the delivery schedule? El horario de entregas. A ver. How many? Do you remember? It was in the first one.
Every Monday.
No, no. How many truck drivers? How many truck drivers? Okay, great. So let's go and say. I'm going to write it here. 25, oops. Again, the same thing? No way. What happened here? Otra vez la misma cosa. No. Tan chévere que íbamos. 25. Bueno, lo vamos a dejar así en clave, ¿ok? No, a ver si sale acá. Ok. 25. Truck drivers. Ok. 25 truck drivers receive the schedule, the delivery schedule. And let's see the last one. It says, how much is the delivery charge? How much?
200.
¿Cómo respondemos eso? Como es en la, como es en, es un precio, ¿verdad?
It's 200.
Ajá, correct. Dollars. Yes, 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 yes. Just one second because this thing is. My God. Okay, I'm going back. I'm going back. Are we okay here? One second. Ya ven que sí se volvió a quedar trabado esto. ¿Por qué? ¿Qué es lo que hace eso? I don't know. Se ha quedado congelada la, el paso de las, de los slides. Solo démosle un segundito. Voy a regresar aquí. Regreso aquí. Ok. Going to close this. And let's go. Here. Ok, entonces me voy a ir acá porque gracias a Dios era la última pregunta. Yeah. So let me share here. And how much is the delivery charge? It's, remember? It's $200, okay? Siempre recuerden de poner el respectivo pronombre y verbo cuando contestan, ¿verdad? Bien. ¿Por qué les digo eso? A veces nosotros decimos, ah, pero si normalmente uno no va a andar contestando la gran respuesta. No, ¿cómo no? Miren, si ustedes no le enseñan al cerebro a ordenar su idea primero desde este momento, después solo van a decir, yeah, no. Pero para armar la oración, ahí se van a volver a perder. Entonces, desde ahorita, comencemos a dar la respuesta con una oración completa, ¿ok? With a complete sentence. Ok. Bien, vamos a ir entonces a lo que continúa. Next. Do you, by the way, does anybody have any question about the activity that we did about the conversation? Questions?
Yes.
No, teacher.
Oh, teacher.
No questions? Okay.
No,
everything
teacher.
Clear? Okay. Ok. Ahorita lo que quiero hacer es mostrarles unas, quiero hacerles unas preguntas y quiero mostrarles unas fotos y de acuerdo a esas fotos vamos a contestar. Ok. Bien. We are going to answer these questions according to the flashcards. Ok. So there we go.
Ok.
Aha. How often do you eat pupusas? You're hungry now. Qué mala la teacher nos pone las pupusas a la hora de la cena.
Sí.
No.
Sí. Yes, teacher, you're right.
Okay, but how often do you eat pupusas, guys?
I sometimes eat pupusas, teacher.
Bien, hasta el momento sabemos cómo contestar esto usando las expresiones de tiempo, ¿ok? Alguien acaba de contestar, pero casi no le pude escuchar, lo oí muy lejos, quise escuchar.
I eat pupusas every day. Every night. Just for dinner.
Every day in the evening. Okay. Correcto?
Yeah. After your class.
After class. Aunque sea nos toca tostarla, right. ¿Verdad? Pero ni modo, porque ya llegaron muy temprano.
Yes.
Okay. Let's see. Mayra, how often do you eat pupusas?
I eat pupusas every day weekend.
Okay. Every weekend. Okay. So I eat pupusas every weekend. Good. Now, how often do you eat pupusas, Alba?
I eat pupusas all Sunday.
Okay, every Sunday. Okay.
Every Sunday.
Okay, good. Now, Juan Diego, how often do you eat pupusas?
Actually, a few hours I take the pupusas.
Oh, so you eat pupusas whenever you want.
yeah, like that.
Okay. So I ate pupusas just a second ago, right? Okay, great. So let's see. Do you eat pupusas every day, Juan Diego?
No, when I have some money. Oh. Just when I have some money.
Okay. So, and when is usually that?
The weekend.
Okay, I eat pupusas on weekends. Good. Great. Thank you very much. Patricia, okay. How often do you eat pupusas?
I eat pupusas every day, in the morning, at noon.
Yay, you are Salvadoran, as a good Salvadorian. Yeah, you are in my team. Okay, in the morning, in the evening, yeah. So you have it for, are you of those people, I mean, who eat pupusas for lunch?
Yes.
Okay, good. So you're in my team. Yeah. Not everybody likes eating pupusas for lunch, right? They usually eat pupusas in the morning or in the evening for dinner, right? But yeah, I love pupusas anytime. So I'm going to write here anytime. Okay. Aquí podríamos separar cada una con comas para que podamos ver que son diferentes expresiones. Okay. Sí, ahí están separaditas por comas para que vean que son diferentes expresiones. Okay. Here we go. David, how often do you eat pupusas?
I eat pupusas on weekends in the afternoon.
Okay, great. Great. So let's continue with another question, okay? We're going to see another question. Please pay attention with the next one. How often do you visit the doctor? How often do you visit the doctor? Linda, how often do you visit the doctor?
I visit the doctor mensualmente.
Okay, monthly.
Monthly.
Uh-huh. I visit the doctor monthly. ¿Va una vez al mes?
Yes.
Okay, we could say also once a month, okay? ¿Se acuerdan que vimos once a day, twice a day, three times a day? Day puede ser month, year, okay? Podemos decir once a month, once a year, y estamos diciendo una vez al año, una vez al mes, okay? So it's the same as if you say twice a month, right? Twice a month, for example, when you receive your salary twice a month, eso es bimensual, ¿verdad? O quincenal. Entonces, in English, could be bi-weekly, okay? Bi-weekly. I'm going to write it down for you to take note of that. Este es solo cultura general, pero les puede servir, okay? Bi-weekly. Cuando se recibe el pago quincenal, okay? Bi-weekly. Que también puede ser twice a month. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now, how often do you visit the doctor, Nestor?
Twice a year.
Okay. Digamos la oración completa.
I visit the doctor twice a year.
Okay, great. Okay.
I was writing the word that you had just.
Oh. Okay.
Bi-weekly. It is bi-weekly, right?
Yes, like this.
Sorry. Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Bi-weekly. And the other is twice a month. Cuando nos pagan quincenal, ¿verdad?
Ok.
Uh-huh. También podríamos decir every 15 days. Ok. Ahí ustedes se pueden mover en cualquiera de esas direcciones. Bi-weekly, twice a month, every 15 days. Ok.
Thank you, teacher.
Ok, good. Now, how often do you visit the doctor, Grecia? Debbie, how often do you visit the doctor?
I usually visit the doctor only when I am sick, teacher.
Okay, good. I usually visit the doctor only when I am sick. Okay, great, good. So we are going to go to the next question. Here we go. How often do you attend a meeting? How often do you attend a meeting? Roxana, how often do you attend a meeting?
I attend a meeting twice a week.
Twice a week, okay. There you are. I attend a meeting twice a week. Thank you, Roxana. Juan Diego, how often do you attend a meeting?
For me, it's very eventually attend a meeting.
So
I don't have a specific day.
Okay. So we could say that. Okay. I attend a meeting in specific dates and times. Okay?
Okay.
I attend a meeting in specific dates and time. Dates and times. Okay.
Okay.
There you are. So let's see. Cecia, how often do you attend a meeting?
I attend a meeting each day.
Every day?
Oh, every day. Correct.
Okay. A meeting every day. Okay, here we go. Alba, how often do you attend a meeting?
I attend a meeting every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday, okay. Los días de semana siempre se escriben con capital letter, okay? Siempre con letra mayúscula. Okay, always. Week, the days of the week, always with capital letter. Now, let's see. Mayra, how often do you attend a meeting?
I think I need it every Friday.
Every Friday. Friday. Excellent. Every Friday. Pablo, how often do you attend a meeting?
I always attend a meeting.
Okay, great. I always attend a meeting. Okay, good, good. Patricia, how often do you attend a meeting?
I attend a meeting every day.
Okay, I attend a meeting every day. Good. Okay, now we are going to the last one and we are going to pass to another activity, very important too. How often do you call clients? How often do you call clients? Linda, how often do you call clients?
I never call clients. My great. Work is only chat.
Ah, great. I never call clients. My work is only via chat. Good. Right. Juan Diego, how often do you call clients?
I don't have clients. But,
okay. I don't call clients.
I don't call clients.
Okay, great. I don't call clients. Good. I don't call clients. Great. David Alejandro, how often do you call clients?
I call clients every afternoon.
Okay. Okay, guys, so now we have an idea using the time expressions that we learn in unit one, and it is okay, right? Now, I want you to see these other pictures. I'm going to show some pictures. See the pictures, and then I'm going to ask what activities you are seeing on each picture, okay? These are leisure activities. Leisure activities. Leisure quiere decir fuera del trabajo, ¿verdad? O sea, en descanso o en horas no laborales, right? Leisure, leisure. Se los voy a escribir para que tomen nota. Ahorita les voy a mostrar some leisure activities. Okay? Leisure activities. I'm going to show the pictures. See the pictures. Then I'm going to ask what activities you are seeing, okay? Okay, what do you see in the first picture? What activity do you see in the first picture?
Read a book.
Correct. Read a book. Excellent. What about this one?
Go to the park. Or
go to the park. Okay. And?
On Sunday.
Ride a bike. Yes, on Sunday. Good. Uh-huh. Ride a bike, go to the park, go out with friends, right? To the park, obviously, because we can't go to enclosed places because of the pandemic. We have to go to the parks, right? Okay. So what do you see in this picture?
Surfing.
Surfing in the beach.
Great. Go surfing, okay? Go surfing. Yes. Now, what do you see in this picture?
Go shopping.
Excellent. What about this one?
Go play soccer.
Play soccer.
Yes. You could say go playing soccer or go, or play soccer. Good. What about this one?
Go to the beach.
Go to the beach.
Go to the beach. Correct. There you are. Okay, now guys, how often do you go shopping, Luz?
I go shopping twice a year.
Twice a year, okay, good. How often do you play soccer, Nestor? No Nestor there? How often do you play soccer?
I play soccer just on Saturday.
Okay, good. Now, who in this virtual room goes surfing? Goes surfing. Who goes surfing? Is anybody here who goes surfing? No?
At the beach?
Yes. Okay, go to the beach, yeah. But I mean surfing. Who does surfing here?
I surfing when I was young. Right now, no.
Okay, I'm sorry, but I couldn't get who was speaking. Let's see. David.
Me, David.
Okay, David. Yeah, I was not sure it was you. Okay, so you know how to surf.
I have the idea.
Okay.
But the practice anymore.
Okay, not anymore. Very good. But okay, I think you enjoyed that. Maybe watching, right? Watching people surfing. So now let's think. How often do you guys go to the beach? How often? Linda?
Tengo un montón de
Okay, yeah. I think everyone here, yeah. Is the same experience. Yeah. Is that because of the time or because of the pandemic?
Las dos.
Okay, I understand. But usually, imagine that we are in a regular time and in regular conditions. How often, guys? How often? Pongamos que iban, pero lo vamos a decir en presente. Do you go to the beach?
I go to the beach twice a year.
Twice a year? Okay, good.
I go to the beach in vacation of December.
Okay. Uh-huh.
I sometimes beach.
Okay, now I couldn't hear the last one. I'm sorry, but I'm going to stop share. Well, no, I'm not stop sharing yet. I just want you to think about this conversation, okay? This is in your manual in page 19. In page 19. Okay. Here we want to see how to use this phrase, how often, okay? And let's see how do they use this when they are speaking, okay? We're talking about the frequency or how frequently we do something or people do something, okay? So in this case, for example, we have John and Anne talking about activities, okay? And the frequency they do those activities. So let's read it. How often do you check your email? Every 2 hours. And you? Well, I try to check it as often as I can. And how often do you call your clients? I often call them once a week on Monday, but I usually call them on Friday to check their order. Do you call clients? Yes, I always call them first thing in the morning. I believe it is important to have contact with them all the time. You're right. Okay. Do you have any question about the vocabulary in this conversation? Questions?
Yes, teacher.
Tell me.
Ahí donde dice John, I try to check it.
I try to check it as often as I can.
Siempre que
often as.
No, tan frecuente como puedo, ¿ok? O tan a menudo como yo puedo. Excuse me?
Es que el often sí lo prendo.
¿Ok?
Pero
as often as, she asking about as often as.
Ok, es que es completo. Es desde as often as I can, ¿ok? Hasta el final. As often as I can. ¿Sí? You see here? Es completa la frase y lo que le está diciendo es tan frecuente como yo puedo. Ok.
Teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Teacher, you can explain how to use them.
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 Ok, them here is a demonstrative. Ok. In this case, let me open a textbook here, a text box. Okay. Estos son los pronombres de objeto, se convierten en un objeto directo, digamos, okay? Entonces, them es para ellos, ¿verdad? ¿Sí? Es como que dijéramos they. Pero después del verbo no vamos, porque ellos son los que reciben la acción, ¿ok? No vamos a poner call they, sino que cuando they recibe la acción del verbo, entonces usamos them, ¿ok? Cuando son el objeto directo, ¿ya?
O sea que es ellos igual, pero depende de una acción para ser utilizado.
Sí, usualmente lo va a encontrar después del verbo. ¿Ok? Después del verbo es cuando usted lo va a utilizar. Por ejemplo, call them, bring them, traer a ellos, ¿verdad? Llamarlos a ellos, ¿sí? Están recibiendo la acción del verbo, ¿ya?
Okay, like you can call them.
Yes, correct.
Okay, correct. I understand. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there you are. Excuse me, Delmi?
Them is parte de los...
Yes, object pronouns. Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Object pronouns. Ahorita solo digo este porque es un tema aparte, ¿verdad? Este es para que entendamos cómo está utilizado acá, en esta conversación. Más adelante lo vamos a ver, ¿ok? Con los demás pronombres. Voy a borrar. Ok. So, how often do you check your email? Every 2 hours. And you? Well, I try to check it as often as I can. And how often do you call your clients? I often call them once a week on Monday, but I usually call them on Friday to check their order. Do you call clients? Yes, I always call them first thing in the morning. I believe it is important to have contact with them all the time. Okay? You're right. Entonces, vamos a escuchar. We want to listen to Delmi and Patricia, please. Delmi is John and Patricia is Anne.
How often do you check your email?
Are you there, Patricia? Yes. We cannot hear you, Patricia.
Y se me está yendo la señal y se me está yendo, pero no sé si es problema mío o es, me saca y me vuelve a entrar.
Oh, sorry to hear that, but yeah, let's try now. You are Anne. Ahorita usted va a hacer el papel de Ana.
Okay. Ya empezamos.
Yes.
Every 2 hours. And you?
Well, I try to check it as often as I can. And how often do you call your clients?
I often call the ones a week on Monday, but I usually call them on Friday to check the order. Do you call clients?
Delmi?
Yeah. Hello?
Yes?
Are you hearing me?
Okay, now we can hear you, but before we couldn't. Okay, start over from Yon. Yes.
Yes, I always call them first thing in the morning. I believe it is important to have contact with them all the time.
And the last part, Patricia?
You are right.
Excellent. Excellent. Okay, now we are going to our manuals because there we have a figure it out or a comprehension check about this conversation. And we have to answer only two questions over there in page 19. So you have a discussion over there, okay? It's kind of a discussion, right? Antes que nada, vamos a ver nuevamente en la conversación algunas cositas importantes. Yeah. We are learning about the the frequency adverbs, okay? The frequency adverbs. And those are words. Those are words that express how frequently we do something, okay? So let's see here the phrases and the words we have in bold. Las palabras que están en negrita, in bold. So let's see, tenemos how often, tenemos often, usually, and always. Okay, these three, often, usually, and always, are frequency adverbs. Okay, so let's read the questions below and let's discuss. How often does Anne check her email? How often does Anne check her email? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's read number two. Why is it important to check the email every day? Why is it important to check the email every day? Okay.
It is important to have contact with them all the time.
Okay. Why? Why? Why is it important? Now, let's answer the first question. How often does Anne check her email? Acordémonos que aquí ya no decimos do you, ¿verdad? Como la hemos estado haciendo, solo entre usted y yo hemos estado preguntando. Aquí ya estamos preguntando de una tercera persona, que es Anne. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que cambia? El auxiliar, ¿verdad? Ahora es does. Cuando agregamos how often, es pregunta de frecuencia, ¿verdad? ¿Con qué frecuencia Ana revisa su email? ¿Ok? So let's read again in the conversation here. Mm-hmm. What does she say?
Every 2 hours.
Ok. Digámoslo en una oración completa.
She,
Anne,
checks her email every 2 hours.
Okay, good. Every 2 hours. Good. Why is it important to check the email every day? Mm-hmm. What do you think? Cuando nos hacen la pregunta why, la respuesta siempre va a decir because. Okay? Because. Because. Para dar una razón de algo, ¿verdad? Para dar una razón del por qué. Entonces, because.
Believe.
What about
it's important to have contact with them all the time.
To have contact with, en este caso quitamos them y ponemos with the clients or with clients. Okay, I'm sorry. With clients. Entonces voy a quitar the. Because, aquí no es to, you, because you have contact with clients through email, right? Esa puede ser una buena razón. Si usted se comunica con los clientes vía email, pues por eso va a ser importante, ¿verdad? Otra razón podría ser because you receive important information or job information, right?
Or documents.
Okay. Mm-hmm. you receive important documents, and files, right? And files. Mm-hmm. So it's really important because it's a way to stay communicated, okay? Stay communicated or to keep in contact with people in our jobs, right? So if you see, we have learned how to use the question, how often, okay? Now, let me go back to the slides para que veamos ya en final y luego nos vamos a ir a practicar esta, la primera conversacioncita y esta, ¿verdad? Vamos a hacer esto. Para ir cerrando acá. Vamos a ver. El concepto, the definition of adverbs of frequency. Okay. The definition of adverbs of frequency. See if I can share this correctly. Yes. Cada vez que estoy conectando el PowerPoint, I'm praying for it to work. Me pongo así en mi mente, que funcione, Señor, que funcione. Ok, no sé qué le está pasando a este PowerPoint. Este fin de semana sí tengo que revisarlo. Bueno, mañana, I think, right? Ok, let's see. Adverbs of frequency. What is the definition of adverbs of frequency? Adverbs are words, okay? Adverbs are words. It's a group of words, okay? Adverbs that change or qualify the meaning of a sentence by telling us how often or how frequently something happens, okay? Vamos a ver, son palabras, they are some words, the adverbs, right? Adverbs of frequency are the adverbs that change or qualify the meaning of a sentence by telling us how often or how frequently something happens. Entonces, si vamos, son palabras o es un grupo de palabras que califican y cambian el significado o le dan el significado a una oración diciéndonos la frecuencia o qué tan frecuentemente algo sucede, ¿verdad? Y usamos estos adverbios de frecuencia para contestar, to answer this question, how often, okay? Cuando nos preguntan, how often do you take English classes? Ah, me están diciendo con qué frecuencia recibo mis clases de inglés. Ah, entonces voy a buscar una de estas palabras, ¿verdad? Vamos a ver cuáles son esas palabras. Which one are these words? Okay. These are the adverbs. Okay. These are the adverbs. Let's see. How to use frequency adverbs. Para que podamos contestar how often, veamos cómo usar los adverbios de frecuencia. How to use frequency adverbs, okay? And here it says, use frequency adverbs to say how frequently an activity happens. Vamos a ver cuáles son estas palabras. Always, usually, normally, often, sometimes, occasionally, seldom, hardly ever, rarely, never. Okay? Vamos a ver. Quiero escucharlos a ustedes con estas pronunciaciones. Okay? With the pronunciation. A ver. Please open your mics and we are going to say it together. Say them together. Okay? Vamos a decirlos todos juntos. Para abajo. Always.
Always. Always.
Usually.
Usually.
Normally.
Normally.
Often.
Often.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Occasionally.
Occasionally.
Seldom.
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 Hardly ever.
Hardly ever.
Rarely.
Rarely.
Never.
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 Okay. These are the frequency adverbs. Okay. They express how frequently an activity happens. Let's see the examples. Okay. Let's see the examples. En esta columna que ven acá, vemos el porcentaje de las veces que sucede una cosa para que podamos usar este adverbio. Okay. If the activity happens the 100%, it means always. Okay. No falta ni una vez, right? Always. If an activity happens a 90% of the times, then we use usually. Usually, it means maybe once they didn't, and in that case, we could say usually. If the activity happens on 80%, then we use normally. Normally, it means not always, not always, not usually, but normally. Okay, normally. So on, right? If an activity happens at 70%, then it goes to be useful to use often, okay? And if it happens a half of the times, okay? Si pasa solo la mitad de las veces y la mitad de las veces no, then we say sometimes, okay? Then we say sometimes, okay? So we can measure this. We can measure to have an idea which adverb we are going to use, okay? So let's see the examples. Let's see the examples here. Uh-huh. I always get up at 5 o'clock.
That's a lie, I never get up at 5 o'clock.
Okay, I always get up late. No, not me. Okay, I always get up at 5 o'clock. I always get up at 5 o'clock. Quiere decir que ninguno de los días, ni siquiera el fin de semana, se levanta tarde, ¿verdad? Sino que todos los días, right? The 100% of the times, okay? This person gets up at 5 o'clock, okay? Next one, he usually drives to work. He usually drives to work. It means that maybe one of the times he goes by bus, right? He takes the bus, okay? So she normally checks her email. It means that it could be that she could miss an email, right? Podría haber obviado o se pasó un email, aunque normalmente lo hace, ¿verdad? Pero bueno, ni modo, hoy no lo hizo, right? Something like that. She normally checks her email. She normally checks her email. Okay. Next one. I often have breakfast at work. I often have breakfast at work. Puede ser que unos días no, ¿verdad? Pero muy frecuentemente. I have breakfast at work, okay? Then, she sometimes uses the microwave. She sometimes uses the microwave. It means that maybe she buys lunch also, right? Or maybe she takes cold food, right? So, yeah. But sometimes she uses the microwave. Now, I occasionally work over the time. Occasionally. Occasionally todavía es menor, ¿verdad? Menos veces. Less times. Okay. En ocasiones, right? Occasionally work over time. Work over time. Overtime significa extra hours. Okay. overtime, extra hours. We seldom take calls at work. Okay, we seldom take calls at work. Seldom, seldom es todavía un poquito más que hardly ever. Okay, seldom es como pocas veces, right? Escasas veces, right? That's seldom. So hardly ever es como nosotros decimos, ah, difícilmente lo hace, bojando. Ni le pidas que se difícilmente se levanta temprano, ¿verdad? O sea, he hardly ever gets up at 5 o'clock, right? So you are not going to ask a favor early in the morning because this person hardly ever, okay? Yeah, it's like lazy person, right? So if we say about getting up early. Pero puede ser también en la forma positiva, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, hardly ever dice una mentira, ¿verdad? Hardly ever says a lie. O sea, he never lies or hardly ever says a lie. Eso ya es positivo, right? Cuando dejamos de hacer una cosa que es mala o cuando la hacemos pocas veces, ah, pues somos buenos, right? So, it's the same thing here, okay? Rarely, rarely. ¿Alguien tiene abierto su audio? Okay, there you are. And then we have never. Never is as if we say no, okay? That never happens. That activity never happens. Okay, then we have I never get late to work. I never get late to work. Entonces, les voy a hacer una ultimita pregunta en este cuadrito. Ok, luego vamos a pasar nuevamente a otras preguntitas y la última conversacioncita, ok? So, how often do you get late to work? Ha, got you guys. Let's see, Luz. How often do you get late to work?
Repeat, please.
How often do you get late to work?
I always get up at 4 o'clock.
Okay, but the question is, how often do you get late to work?
Cuando me voy al trabajo o regreso no, o salgo del trabajo.
When you get to work. Okay. Espérenos un ratito, Luz. Voy a preguntarle a otra persona para que me responda, okay? How often do you get late to work, Néstor?
It's hardly ever, teacher.
Okay, but sometimes
because,
no.
because we have the machine, so we have to mark, and it's difficult to not attend.
Okay.
To be present.
Okay, okay, good. Luz, get late significa llegar tarde. Okay, get late. Entonces la pregunta es, how often do you get late to work?
I never get late at work.
Great, Luz, excellent. That's the right question. And I was hoping that you say that because I see you are responsible. You are always early in the class. So that's what I ask you. Okay, so Patricia, how often do you get late to work?
Teacher.
Yes.
So using the verb to be, answer
okay, you can say.
Adding, agregando el comentario de ella, sería she is never late to work.
Correct, and also
so the verb to be if before the adverb of frequency.
Yes.
It's going to be, it's going before the frequency adverbs. So that the verbs, los otros verbos van después de la frequency adverbs.
Correct.
It's interesting, teacher.
Thank you very much for your observation, because I was missing to show you this. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you for your observation, Nestor. So now look at this. This is the place of an adverb in a sentence. Okay. This is the place of an adverb in a sentence. If you see here, tenemos el sujeto, the subject. Subject.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Plus the adverb, plus mm-hmm. the verb, mm-hmm. plus the complement. Okay. Okay, aquí tenemos tres ejemplos. Here we have mm-hmm. three examples. ¿Sí?
Okay. Okay.
Here we have, for example, I often go to the beach on weekends.
Okay.
Okay. Where is often? Is between the subject and the verb.
The verb. Okay. Okay.
Then, my boss could be she or he, right? Sometimes visits potential clients. Potential clients. Okay. ¿A dónde está el adverbio acá? Where is the adverb?
Between.
It's between my boss, the subject.
The subject.
And the verb. Okay. And number three, my mm-hmm. husband and I always have breakfast at home. Let's see, where is the adverb? Always is between the subject and the verb.
And the verb.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Pero también, sometimes, podría ir al inicio, right? O sometimes puede ir al final. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Por el momento, vamos a aprender esta manera, ¿ok? Esta manera no es rígida, ¿ok? Mm-hmm. Pero es la general, ¿ok?
Ok.
Esta es la forma general.
Sí. So,
pero en los sí. Ejemplos, ajá. Tell me.
En los ejemplos con el verb to be, mm-hmm. va primero antes, después del pronombre y después va el adverbio de frecuencia.
Correct.
Es, ajá.
Correct.
Okay.
So, for example, eso lo vamos a ver ahí en el manual. Okay. But here, I am never late. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I am, or they are always late. Okay, a manera de ejemplo, yes, as a manner of example, okay?
Yes, 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 teacher.
The verb to be is in a different place, okay?
Yes, yes.
With the verb to be, the adverb of frequency goes in a different place, okay?
Yes,
it goes
yes, yes.
after, right?
Yes.
No decimos, yes. I never am, okay?
Yes, yeah. Eso estaba viendo, teacher, que no se podía.
Okay, okay, good. Muchas veces van a escuchar, por ejemplo, pero eso es como para enfatizar, like emphasize. Mm-hmm. They always are late, okay? And someone who is really angry or pissed off, right? Yeah. It's like they change the order. But we can say in this way. Mm-hmm. This is the general way.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Now I'm going to stop sharing. Y vamos a cambiar. Ya les había dicho que íbamos al breakout room, ¿verdad? Pero ya solo tenemos 10 minutitos. Okay. Así que lo vamos a hacer aquí en pleno. ¿Ya? Aquí en pleno. Vamos a ver. Y para mañana tendremos dos breakout rooms. Ok. Déjenme ir. Acá. Vamos a regresar a esto. Here we go. Okay. Mayra, ask the question. How often do you? Y escoge una de las actividades de acá. Y de una vez escoge, okay, a un compañero para preguntarle. Okay. Luego, ese compañero que le preguntaron, hace la pregunta con otra actividad a otro compañero. Y así vamos en cadenita. Okay. ¿Se entendió?
Teacher, me moví un ratito.
Ok, no, vamos a hacer preguntas y respuestas. Ok, vamos a hacer preguntas y respuestas.
¿Cómo?
Ok, ¿cómo la vamos a hacer? Voy a escoger a uno de ustedes, el primero que va a empezar la actividad. Va a preguntar, how often do you, y hace, agarra cualquiera de estas actividades, escoge a un compañero. Luego, ese compañero responde y hace otra pregunta en cadenita, ¿verdad? Con otra actividad de las que están acá, que son las leisure activities. Y el que responde otra vez hace pregunta a otro. ¿Ok? ¿Estamos hasta ahí? Ok. Let's start. Alba, please help me with the first one.
Primero la pregunta.
Yes, escoja a quién se la va a hacer o de una vez en la pregunta diga el nombre de a quién le está haciendo la pregunta.
Ok. Patricia, how often go to the park?
I go to the park on the weekend.
Okay, ahorita vamos a utilizar los frequency adverbs. Okay.
Okay.
Acordémonos dónde va el adverbio de frecuencia, va entre el sujeto y el verbo. Entonces, I usually go to the park. Ajá. Ahí le puede agregar lo que usted quiera. ¿Verdad?
Ok, sí,
sí. Ok.
Sorry, es que me habló mi
gente. Ok. Ok, Patricia. Vamos a ver. ¿Empezamos otra vez, Albita?
Ok. How often read your book?
Okay, do you, how often do you read a book?
A book. Cecilia.
I sometimes read a book.
Okay, great. I sometimes read a book. Okay. Uh-huh. Good, 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 good. Ahora, acá le podemos agregar lo que nosotros, la actividad que nosotros queramos, perdón, la no actividad, la time expression que nosotros queramos. Por ejemplo, I sometimes read a book twice a month. Okay? I sometimes. Yeah, porque hay meses que no lo leo. Okay? ¿Sí?
Okay.
Okay. Aquí le podemos agregar. Las time expression, the time expressions goes at the end. Okay? Goes, they go at the end of the sentence. Usually. Okay? They could go at the beginning too, but in this case, I think at the end will be the general rule. Okay.
Okay.
You said Grecia, right?
Okay. Continúo.
Yes, please.
Okay. Um, Delmi.
Yes.
Delmi, how often go to the shopping?
How often do you go shopping?
How often do you go shopping?
I rarely go to the shopping.
I rarely go shopping. La actividad se llama go shopping. Go shopping. Ahora, si usted quiere decir ir al centro comercial, go to the shopping mall. Okay, or the shopping center, whatever you want to say, but in that case. Aquí en este caso es go shopping, la actividad. Correct?
I rarely go shopping.
Excellent. Now, you please ask a question.
Diego, how often do you bike a ride in the park?
Right now, very rarely.
Okay, now ask a question, please.
So, to Roxana, how often you read a book and take a coffee?
I usually read a book.
Okay, I usually read a book. Y le puede agregar una time expression.
I usually read a book in the afternoon.
Okay, good, good, very good. Now ask a question, please.
Le pregunto a alguien, sigo.
Yes, please, you have to pick a classmate.
Cecia, ¿ya participó?
Yes. Yes, she participated, yes. But it is okay. You can try with her too.
Okay. Néstor Ariel.
Okay.
I often or
how often
you say,
how often do you
visit the beach?
I sometimes visit the beach, go to the beach, just on vacation.
Okay.
Okay. Now pick a classmate, Nestor.
I don't know who is.
We have Linda. David.
Linda.
Okay, Linda.
Okay.
How often do you go to the gym? I mean,
¿cómo? No lo escuché bien.
How often do you go to the gym?
I never go to the gym.
Okay. Neither do I. We are two.
Okay.
Yeah. I never go to the gym. So you are in my team, Linda. Yay.
Okay.
Nice. Okay, guys, it's 10 o'clock now. So we cover all the material for tonight. And I hope everything is okay. But if you have any question, please tell me right now. Okay, do you have any question?
No.
No, teacher.
Everything clear? Is it everything clear?
Yes.
Everything is clear.
Okay, great. Great. So today is Daisy's turn, okay? Are you saying? Okay, yes. So, guys, please remember, homework from today and Friday has to be submitted Friday after midnight. The class. Okay, so please, please do that.
Okay.
Okay, guys, have a good rest. Have a good night. Now, thank if you, you want to go to see the match, you may go. Okay, so.
Thank you, you too, teacher.
Okay, okay. Bye-bye.
Blessing.
Bye.
Blessing,
bye.
Blessing. Night night.
Bye. Good night, everybody.
Night night. Bye. Hello, Daisy. How are you doing?
I'm so sleepy.
Are you sleepy? Oh my god. ¿Está desvelada?
Sí, no, es que me tomé un té, entonces me relajo mucho.
Ah, okay, okay, okay. So it is not for the class, right?
What?
It is not for the class, right?
Yes, in the class.
Oh my god. Okay.
Porque si no después no puedo dormir.
Sí, se queda como activada, ¿verdad? Mm-hmm. Sí, es normal, es normal. Las pantallas activan. Activan, okay, do you have any question about the contents or anything you want to know?
Con lo que yo me confundí, creo que fue en la clase de ayer, donde decíamos lo de third person, or the verbs. To the add the little s in the verb.
Mm-hmm.
Entonces, no sé si ahí me puede más okay. O menos ubicar porque si sí, sí me pierdo.
Okay, okay, let's see. We have let me share the board. Okay, I'm going to write on the board. Okay, here we are. I'm going to select this one. Here. So, en una oración, los sujetos, ¿verdad? Pueden ser plurales y pueden ser singulares. Puedo estar hablando de una sola persona, como puedo estar hablando de varias personas. Entonces, tenemos los sujetos, serían, en todo caso, right? In general, I, you, vamos a ponerlos así, we, and they. You puede ser singular and you puede ser plural, puede ser ustedes, right? So, when we are talking about activities that this subject are do daily, for example, okay, then I write the activity or I say the verb in the base form. For example, I type letters. Yeah? I type letters. Entonces, el verbo aquí es type, ¿verdad? Type. Quiere decir que conjugado, en este caso, para nosotros, en español aquí dice, yo escribo cartas. ¿Ok? Ahora, you type, no cambio, right? It doesn't cambio. Change. Type letters. Yeah? We type letters and they type letters, right? Ahora, si voy a esto, sí tenemos que cambiar, ¿ok? Gramaticalmente me exige el inglés o el idioma inglés que le tengo que agregar una S al verbo para que sea una tercera persona. Como que nosotros le tuviéramos que cambiar el final, ¿verdad? Escribo, sí. Escribes, escribimos, escriben, él escribe. ¿Ok? Nosotros le quitamos, ¿verdad? Pero ellos le ponen la S. Entonces, types. ¿Ok? Types letters. She igual. Types letters. It types letters. Okay. Si lo hace automáticamente, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, alguna aplicación, type letters or transcribe, right? So, veamos acá que la forma de los verbos, como en español, se conjuga, ¿verdad? Sí. Entonces, en este caso vemos acá que para I, you, we, they, el verbo no cambia. Para he, she, it, le agregamos letra S. ¿Ok?
Pero como y dependiendo algunas... también del verbo, ¿verdad?
Yes. No, o entre... Sí, porque no le voy a agregar S nada más, a los, porque hay una pequeña reglita, ¿verdad? En que me voy a ir a ese slide para que lo vea. ¿Ok? En que tenemos, we have some verbs. And depending on the letter that this verb ends, okay, we add ES or IES, okay? Vamos a ir. Okay, creo que... Ok, acá tenemos unos verbos que solamente se les agrega la letra S. Mire, en esto solo hemos agregado letra S. ¿Por qué le agregamos solo letra S? Porque la letra en que terminan así nos lo exige, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, if they end in a letter E or in a letter K or another E, these are E's almost. Ah, letter D, letter N, okay? Dependiendo de cómo termina el verbo, así le agregamos. En este caso, estos verbos, write, writes, check, checks, organize, organizes, schedule, writes, balance, balances, take out, takes out, clean up, cleans up, send emails, sends emails, okay? Pero tenemos, we have to remember, tenemos que recordar these two rules, okay? Verbs ending in ch, CH, right? S, letter S. S. In this case, it's sh, o, x. We add letters ES. For example, watch termina en una ch, ¿verdad? Es explosiva y es sin voz, ¿ok? Right? No tiene. Entonces, le ponemos ES. ES. Entonces, watch, watches. She watches she watches TV, for example. Ella mira la tele. She watches TV. Now, guess termina en una S, ¿verdad? So, guesses. Guesses. La pronunciación de esto es completa. S, like this, S. Right? Finish, finishes. Go, goes. Fix, fixes. Ahora veamos que hay otros verbos que terminan en la letra Y. They end in the letter Y. Ok. En esto lo que tenemos que ver es que el verbo, si termina la última sílaba así, con una consonante y la letra Y, entonces sí le voy a poner esta terminación. Yes, I'm going to write I-E-S. Okay, study, studies. Carry, carries. Fly, flies. Okay? Bien, ahora veamos. Para la forma negativa, es que le agregamos does. Pero ahí sí ya no le agregamos S al verbo. ¿Ok?
Ah,
exacto. Entonces me voy a ir al al a la to the board, I'm sorry, to the board. Yeah. And here we are going to see that. Okay. Si yo quiero decir la forma negativa de esto, yeah, I will say a las de tercera persona here, okay, he doesn't, okay, podríamos hacerlo así, does not es la forma larga, ¿verdad? Larga. Uh-huh. Pero como hablamos así más bonito, para oírnos más bonito, le ponemos he doesn't
type,
yeah, without letter S, without uh-huh. letter S. Ouch. Algo pateada la letra. Ok. A ver. Recuerde ahorita usted una de las actividades. Veamos. Cualquier actividad y me dice para she. ¿Qué actividad hace ella? What does she do?
She checks her email.
Okay, y si yo digo la negativa sería
she doesn't check her email.
Correct. Okay, perfect. Easy. En la positiva, usted dijo she checks. Para la negativa, le quito la S y le pongo does not or doesn't. ¿Verdad? Ajá.
Este que ese es el que funciona, ¿verdad? Como el auxiliar.
El auxiliar es el, la, la veces de no, ¿verdad? No. Uh-huh. Ella no revisa. Yeah, mm-hmm. she doesn't. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Sí,
es que
okay.
Es donde yo me entiendo.
Okay. ¿Y ahora cómo lo mira?
No sé, si llama clarito.
Okay, Daisy.
Sí, sí, sí.
Ajá. Okay, veamos otra. Organize meeting, for example. Organize meetings. Organize meetings. So, si le ponemos, vamos a hacerlo aquí. Perdón. Voy a agarrar otro y voy a poner acá, ya uniendo los dos, okay? Vamos a poner, she organizes meetings. Yeah. Okay. Ahora, para la forma negativa, ¿cómo sería?
Sería she doesn't organize meetings.
Okay. Correct. Y ahí es la cuestión. Okay. So this is the way to use the conjugation for the third person. Tercera persona son he, she, it. Okay?
Okay. Yo he descargado la aplicación de Duolingo.
Okay, ajá.
Entonces ahí vengo yo en el bus practicando porque también me pone también que traduzca de inglés y a español.
Okay.
Y a veces me pone también que lo hable. Y son oraciones largas y me pone a veces un texto y le pregunta de qué está hablando acá. Entonces sí me pone las observaciones.
Uh-huh.
Siento que ahí me complementa con la clase.
Okay, okay. Uh-huh. Okay, good, good. It's so good that you to practice. It's very important to practice. Y También puede entrar a los links que hay en el manual. ¿Se ha fijado? Cuando usted abre su manual hay unos links ahí donde usted puede hacer ejercicios relacionados con el tema que estamos viendo, ¿verdad? Para que le ayude. Esas son actividades ex aula, ¿verdad?
Sí, lo voy a checar porque eso sí no lo había visto.
Ajá, y en el manual normalmente están en la primera página de la unidad. ¿Ok? Normalmente están en la primera página donde inicia cada unidad, ahí está los links para que vaya y haga esos ejercicios o haga esas lecturas, haga esas listening activities, ¿verdad? Hay videos, hay muchas cosas ahí que le pueden ayudar, ¿verdad? Para reforzar los temas. Ajá, que acabemos.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, is there anything else I can help you with?
Sí. Yes, sí.
Okay.
Mi confusión.
Okay, so you don't have any other question?
No.
Okay, but I'm happy that you could get this in the right way, okay? Yeah, y no tenga pena siempre, si tiene una consulta o algo, está también el chat de WhatsApp para que haga la pregunta, ¿verdad? Okay?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, then see you tomorrow in the class, right?
See you tomorrow, teacher.
Okay, have a good night, Daisy.
Thank you.
Bye.